Hello, my dearest friends. Welcome back to our channel. I'm here again. I'm back. We are walking in our local park, the embankment, together with Nina. It's a wonderful, very hot, sunny summer day. It's Monday. We decided to have a short walk, even though it's extremely hot now, because we need to go to the local post office. And while we were walking near the panorama of the Stalingrad battle, we saw in the new exhibition there, the new photo exhibition there, dedicated to the Stalingrad Spring. It's so amazing, my dearest friends. There used to be another exhibition there about Leningrad during the Second World War, during the Great Patriotic War, about the blockade of Leningrad, about the time when Leningrad was blocked. And frankly speaking, it was a very interesting, a very informative exhibition, but for me it was horrible because there were such horrible photos there, and my children were extremely impressed. And I know much about that time, and I was not so impressed because I knew that, but it was still very hard for me, and I had no courage to show you that exhibition. I just had no strength to speak about that time, to show you that photos. Oh, it was horrible. And this new exhibition, it's so amazing, it's so cheerful. It's about the second birth of our city, and I decided to share this exhibition with you. So if you're interested, my dearest friends, stay with us. Let's have a look at it. Let's go. Hello, hello everyone. Welcome back to our channel. Welcome to Volgograd, former Stalingrad. You can see Nina, she's happy. She's on her bicycle, she's riding a bike. Such a sunny summer day, and we're in front of the panorama of the Stalingrad battle. Unfortunately, when I started filming this short excursion for you, something suddenly happened to the sound, and I had to record another audio track for you, not to torment your ears. But don't get upset, my dearest friends, you'll hear the original audio very soon. This amazing exhibition is called the Stalingrad Spring. It is not literally about the spring in my hometown. The word spring is a beautiful metaphor here. It is about the transformation of the ruined city after its second birth, after the victory in the Stalingrad battle on the 2nd of February 1943. I'm sure that you know, my friends, that this date was the beginning of the Soviet counter-offensive. My dearest Stalingrad was finally free. It started breathing again. It was eager to live. The troops were still fighting for our freedom somewhere near the city. But the ordinary people, mostly women and small children, who had survived the Stalingrad battle, just started trying to restore their homes, streets and lives from scratch. The city was totally ruined, and it's even said that Stalin was told that it was easier and cheaper to build a new city near the ruined one. But this was not permissible for the Soviet Union. Stalingrad was the symbol of our strength. Ruined but never defeated, it was bound to be reborn. What is more, the local people didn't want to leave the streets that they loved so much. They started living an ordinary life, just like there was no war around them. And they finally began to smile. The children returned back to schools and kindergartens, even though there were no buildings for them. But everyone was already dreaming of the future. On these Soviet photos, you can see one of the kindergartens of the Red October district of Stalingrad. There are smiling Soviet children walking in the streets with their teachers, while their mothers are restoring the city and working at the local factories. And you can see that these children look pretty happy. Well, my dearest friends, it's not surprising. They are alive, and they are going to grow and live. And the children do not usually need much to feel happy. You can see that it's such a nice sunny day on these photos. Such small happy faces. And you can see the contrast, the buildings behind the children. I want to pay your attention, to draw your attention to this. You can see the buildings behind these smiling children. Everything is ruined. And of course, the city needs food, it needs bread. Here you can see the first bread for the citizens of Stalingrad. It's a drugstore. Временное жилье, it's a temporary, not an apartment or something like this. Girls are living in this carriage. Shop, another shop, and here you can also see such a city inside of a city. It's a temporary, such a small temporary city for the workers of the factory, of the tractor factory, because nobody has any apartment, everything is ruined. That's why people live in such things. You can see such a, oh, it used to be a banya. It's written that it's a banya, but then it turned into a, I don't know, I do not remember this word either. And now people live here. And here, well, people need to live somewhere, but they have no apartments, absolutely nothing. You can see, it's their house. Mothers with babies. Колхозники, восстановление дорог и мостов, наш долг перед Родиной. These are the Stalingrad trams. The first water. People are building roads, railways. Товарищи сталинградцы, все силы на восстановление городского хозяйства, водопровода, городского транспорта, связи, жилого фонда. You can imagine how hard it was. Our railway station. Oh, these are the dead bodies of the German army, and people are trying to collect them somehow and take them away. Очистка берега Волги. It's part of the central district. It used to look like this. It's a theater. A girl standing near the line. Oh, I do not know this word in English, but this building, it still exists, and maybe you have already seen it in my videos. And by the way, it looks just the same way now. And here you can see how the city was trying to return back to normal life. It is a festival, a holiday dedicated to the 1st of September in 1945. It's the day when all the children return back to school, the beginning of the school year. And you can see that there are so many people. Everyone was going to study again, like there was nothing special, even though it was still the last year of the war. There is a concert, and here you can see a temporary circus. And it's a ruined circus. That is why a temporary one appeared there. Смотри, Нина, вот уже город более-менее восстанавливается, видишь? Смотри, Нинок. Посмотри, Нинусь. Подарки трудящимся Сталинграда из Казани. Смотри, это нам из Казани прислали подарки, посуду разную. Потому что у людей ничего своего не было, и из других городов, которые пострадали меньше, им присылали подарки. Саратов, Сталинграду. Our neighbors from Саратов. Поможем быстрее восстановить героический Сталинград. Кто-то дерево нам прислал. Братский привет трудящимся освобожденных районов от туркменского народа. На восстановление героического Сталинграда. You can see that there was such an amazing atmosphere of friendship. All other cities send us presents. Wow. Such young boys. They are learning how to work at a factory. Well, I can see that it's a cover of a famous Soviet magazine, Огонек. 20 ноября 43 года. Young girl working at a factory. It's the Stalingrad tractor factory. 1944. Немецкие военнопленные на расчистке улиц. Немецкие военнопленные на разборе руин завода «Красный Октябрь». You can see this exhibition. It has two sides. It's the second side. Nina saw this group of athletes, girls, athletes, running. Сейчас посмотрю. Young girls, students. Все силы на восстановление родного Сталинграда. Thank you very much for watching this video. I hope that you liked it. See you very soon. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Nina is a coach today.